Hello all, welcome to our poster titled Assistive Diagnosis in Ophthalmology Using Deep Learning Based Image Retrieval. Chronic diabetes causes complete loss of vision in 2% of the population, while 10% of the people have severe visual impairment. This can, however, be slowed down by early detection of certain anatomical changes in the fundus images. Now, grading a retinal fundus image is a step-by-step process which is time-consuming and strenuous. The accuracy also depends on the workload of the graders as well as their own expertise. Especially in high population areas, maintaining the quality standards can be challenging. We hence propose a system that retrieves labeled images with similar appearance every time it is presented with an unclassified image, and obviously we use deep learning for it. We also compare the performance of the different objective functions like contrastive, histogram, and triplet loss. Lastly, we show that the learned network parameters can be adapted to other disease type without necessitating retraining. We perform our experiments using the Kaggle datasets provided by the IPACS, which consist of 89,000 images divided into train and validation sets, the Messidor dataset with 1,200 images used for testing, and the Indian diabetic retinopathy dataset with 516 images. Our pre-processing step includes border removal, local average color subtraction, and hue normalization. We do this mainly to prevent the network from ranking similarity based on background color. Depending on the objective function, we use multiple images simultaneously across Siamese network with shared weights. We use VGG19 and ResNet 50 architectures. In principle, any feature extractor can be used. We replace the final layers of these networks with a layer of 128 nodes, thus representing the number of dimensions in our latent space. We use the ReLU activation function for all our layers and Adam optimizer for gradient update. We train the network such that the images belonging to similar pathologies lie closer to each other in the latent space, and images with different pathologies remain apart. If we observe that for all three datasets, we get a higher sensitivity score with the contrastive loss and the higher specificity score with the histogram loss. However, triplet loss isn't far behind. The following TSNE plot shows the latent representation of images learned by the network on a 2D manifold. You can see the clear clusters of healthy, mild, moderate, and severe diabetic retinopathic images. While the presence of neighboring clusters also indicate the progressive nature of the disease, the difficulty of the problem can also be emphasized by the fact that some images actually lie at the borderline, which means that it is difficult to assign them into one class or the other. We evaluated our trained algorithm on the diabetic macular edema dataset, and this proves the fact that this learned feature representations are task independent. Here you can see the heat map of positively and negatively activated regions of an image, which shows the region the network focuses on and considers important for retrieval. In conclusion, there is no clear winner between the three losses. However, contrastive and histogram performs a little bit better. We show that the trained network can be repurposed for a different task, provided the image domain remains the same. If you have any questions, please refer to our publication or contact me via an email. I thank you all for listening and wish you a nice day.